Now, women are just as likely to post misogynistic messages online as men. That's the finding of a study of 200,000 tweets by the Centre for Analysis for the Analysis of Social Media at the think tank Demos. Well, joining me now, technology writer and broadcaster Kate Bevan. Hi there, Kate.
Hi.
does it surprise you?
I think it would surprise me if it were a bigger and more representative study. I think Jamie Bartlett, who wrote the study, would probably be the first to agree that it's actually quite a small sample size. It's a very narrow snapshot. And I think one of the things we don't know is whether the tweets that are supposed to come from women actually have come from women, because we don't know who's actually behind a Twitter account. It does surprise me a bit if that's, if we accept that that's true, and again with the caveats, it does surprise me a bit, but not hugely. I've seen women give other women a hard time on Twitter and on Facebook over things they feel strongly about.
And there's the degree. I mean, how did they assess what was abuse and what wasn't abuse? I mean,
they took a range of tweets from a few days, and then narrowed it down to pull out two specific words.
Okay.
And then looked at the context around those words and extrapolated from that. Which is why I think this is an interesting start on doing a dive into the data on whether this is actually true, what the scale of abuse is. It certainly doesn't paint the whole picture, and I think it's very wrong to extrapolate hugely from that one finding. It's a really good and interesting start. I'd like to see a lot more work done on it.
And one wonders whether it is a reflection of what is happening out there in the real world, or whether that it actually is exclusively online because of the anonymity regarding it, and actually probably a lot of the abuse is aimed at people who are in the public domain. Mm-hmm. Is that right?
Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't go to a pub and expect somebody to walk up to you and start calling you names or telling you you're an idiot for your opinions. And I think actually that should be your benchmark of behaviour online. Would you do that in the pub? And if you wouldn't, why would you do it online? But it certainly happens. I've had a bit of it. Some of my friends have had much worse of it. So it's definitely a thing. The question is, what we haven't done really with this is quantify it in any meaningful way. It's just a start. And
I wonder if it affects how you, as the recipient of it, deal with it. Because some people that I know will retweet what is said about them and make a witty comment. Mm. Others will just hit the block or the mute button. I mean, it can be perpetuated by how you respond.
It can, but that's in effect victim blaming. I think the approach of retweeting and making somebody look like an idiot is a brilliant one. It's not one I take because it, for me, I don't like more descending on me, but I completely get that and I rather admire it. I tend to mute, and so that it's not appearing in my timeline, but the person who's sending it doesn't know that they're not being received.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's the women thing. When you first read the headline of the report,
That's not actually the headline of the report. That's a line that's been pulled out of it, actually.
Okay, what's the headline?
I can't remember what the headline was, but I actually read the report earlier today, the full report, and that's just one line in it. And I think also it's quite misleading just to focus on that one line. So it's, again, it's a snapshot and from a very tiny cross-section of the data.
I wonder if the media doesn't help the situation by generating a lot. I mean, we in the media talk about it a lot, and there are certain programmes, entertainment mostly, that actually like to generate this sort of discussion. It gets them publicity and they get a wider audience.
Yeah, I think that's a really important point. So you get something like a big entertainment programme that has a provocative discussion going on. Of course people are going to pile in and comment on Twitter. Twitter is the kind of stream that goes alongside what's happening on television at the moment. And so I think the broadcasters could be a lot more responsible about this as well, about not fueling it. That's not to say that you should ban contentious subjects from being talked about on television, but maybe the broadcaster could step back and apply the what I call the what could possibly go wrong test.
Kate, good to talk to you. Thanks for coming in.